where did that come from? Mm. I was in a familiar relationship in that moment. And it was that relationship that I had with my mother. Knowing that, well, you're with me and you're supposed to love me, right? And this is supposed to work. And, you know, and so, you know, I'm supposed to accept this. And then I realized he reminded me of her. And from that moment, you know, I, you know, had to get some more conversations going on with one of my girlfriends, a counselor. But then I realized, I was like, you know what? Her love was toxic too. It's just toxic. It's unstable. You can't hold on to it. It may be here today. It may be gone tomorrow. You know, it may show up. It may not. I mean, it was some unstable love. And that's what I was in with him. And that was the hardest part for me to, one of the hardest things for me to do was leave it, because I had empathy and compassion, because I thought he really desired something that looked normal, but he just could never hold on to it. No matter how hard he tried. And again, there's a cycle in years and years and years of 2-year marriages here, 2-year relationship. This is him. And here was, I was caught now in his 2-year cycle. I showed him, participated in the very thing that he was already doing behind me. And it was hard, because you know what I wanted to do? I wanted to help him prove everybody wrong. We can make it longer than 2 years, right? We can make it 3 years. We can, no. It was toxic, and he was committed to that toxicity. And I remember once on one of my outs, I said, look, it was toxic. It was unhealthy, and I couldn't stay. And he says, even if it was toxic, you were supposed to stay. Let me tell you something. When I heard the man that I loved so much say that to me, and he was serious, I knew I went no contact. I was sick. No matter how many times I ever talked to him after that, internally, it was a complete block. I will never be with a person. And I would never tell my kids.